This is the co-main event of the evening. Stepping into the blue corner, the challenger, Tony Hope. Kamren, Burton.
The champ. Kamren, Burton. I've been watching on the competition. Oh, yeah. I've seen everyone in Kamren's life. I watch cocaine kids. I sell the bleeding spots. I sell the bloody spits. A lot of shit on. Talk about the life back. Quick, damn. I got a shit to it, yeah, it's in all my waist line. And rid of my cool, yeah, I'm sipping on bloodline. On blood of my brothers, yeah, you know we gon' send rhyme. 5-5-6, make spin rhyme. Dump that block, make sit down. Anywhere we up, gon' spray rhyme. I'ma see how that Draco work. I'ma see how that Draco twerk. Talking on the lady, don't get your hair. You slide big key, you thought it was a verse. I'ma fix it, I ain't talking who's it work. Let's see how that Uzi work. I'm sorry. Let's see how that Uzi work. Let's see how that Uzi work. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this next fight is 5 2-minute rounds for the NFC's Bantamweight Muay Thai Champion. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this 21-year-old has an amateur record, 6 victories, 1 defeat. He stands 6'2" tall, weighing in at 136.2 pounds. Fighting out of Atlanta, representing Bangkok Boxing, the former NFC Bantamweight champion and the challenger, the Tony Hope. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, this 22-year-old has a record 10 victories, 1 defeat, and 1 draw. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 133.2 pounds. Fighting out of Gainesville, Georgia, representing Full Throttle MMA, the champion,
Kamren Burton.
Tony Hawk. Kamren Burton, not. Here we go. Five rounds scheduled for this title rematch.
Tony immediately imposing this space and as well stepping in. Kamren throwing hot though as soon as Tony gets within range.
Here's what separates Kamren from every other opponent Tony Hope has had is that Tony likes to set the pace. Kamren Burton really doesn't let him do that.
Nope.
And very wise, look at Kamren holding on to that underhook, not letting him free that long arm and start unloading elbows. He's keeping his hips close, very smart.
He's doing a great job staying tight in the clinch.
And you know what, you may have to get thrown once or twice, or 12 times. Better than eating a flesh elbow, as
heavy
we saw earlier.
There. Tony with a heavy body kick to counter the spin.
Look at the head movement of Tony Hope. That's something a little new.
Possibly something he worked on in prep for this fight.
Well, he knows Kamren Burton likes that big, heavy overhand.
He does. Ooh, did he just kick his kick?
Yeah, they both just collided shins.
Ooh.
Both kicking. Those do not feel good.
Ooh, heavy leg kicks from Tony Hope.
And I like the way Kamren Burton stopped his circling and threw that heavy right hand.
These Tony Hope
fighters that aren't going to be amateurs much longer.
Another heavy leg kick from Tony and followed by a body kick. Kamren pressing in with some heavy leather. Getting back into the clinch, trying to land some strikes here and there. Tony trying to maintain control as he's almost swept by Brandon there.
First round did not disappoint. Exactly what we expected. Tony Hope using the clinch. Kamren Burton with lightning quick speed, the big heavy overhand. Great first round.
I would know who to give that one to, Jim.
Here's the X Factor, Luff. I think this is why last time that decision was a little controversial. Tony Hope, he's better in the clinch. Last time he hit more sweeps and avoid tie breaks scored more heavily. They prefer landing more punches, throws more volume. And it's hard to not score that more heavily with your eyeballs. You see one guy landing more shots over the top and throwing more punches. A lot of boxing volume versus elbows, punch control, additional Muay Thai strength. That's important. A lot of traditional Muay Thai training, so that's going to go to the guy with the better Thai training. But when you're on an MMA show, you've got judges that primarily do MMA. They're going to score that boxing a little bit more favorably.
Ooh.
Can we just give Kamren Burton props for being able to throw a head kick that high?
Very impressive. He got it all the way up there to Tony's head.
Spinning heel kicks, spinning elbows. These guys are putting it all out there.
Seeing a little bit of everything here, Jim.
Burton going to the body, hitting twice, once with a hand, once with a shin.
Tony trying to throw those front kicks in order to really start messing with Kamren's ability to change distances here and close in on him. Big knee from Toby right there.
He does Tony. So much damage with those knees. They're so long. Where most people can hit a straight right hand, he can hit a knee. Wow, listen to that leather. These boys
that was
are
a heavy
throwing.
Body shot from Kamren right there.
Hope doing a good job of keeping his chin down. He's eating a couple of those right hands.
Another sweep.
But they're hitting
Tony.
Him on the top of the head.
30 seconds left in the round.
That was a good right over the top.
Tony, once again, trying to counter those big overhands with knees and straight teeps. That was a fast spinning heel kick. Big two by Kamren.
He walked right through that kick. He used that as his opportunity to step right through.
Big body kick as they trade the body kick for the overhand there.
Kamren Burton having a lot of success getting inside. Every time Tony Hope throws one of those kicks, he's stepping right into that right hand.
Back. We can steal it. If we bridge this gap, I gotta can stop. See you through the curtains of the waterfall. I gotta stay at range. I gotta start landing a few more strikes. When I lost it, yeah, you held my hand, but I tossed it. Didn't understand you were waiting. As I dove into the waterfall. Hope's doing a good job of keeping the chin down. He's taking on the forehead. Seen him looking even a little peaked.
Nobody pushes the pace like Burton. He does not stop.
Big, heavy two from Burton, followed by a head kick.
He eats a straight right coming in.
Tony eats that one. Keeps moving, though. Both these gentlemen have very much upped their game since the last time they fought. Boom, big overhand again by Kamren. Spinning back fist.
God, these guys are both so good.
Big kick.
While Burton is blocking those with the arms, those still add up. When there's no shin guards, you feel that. You're still catching a shin bone on your arm.
Big 1-2. Tony stepping in with a hard cross. Back into the clinch, though.
Elbow! 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 Yes.
Burton with the elbow. 30 seconds here in round number three.
Another
clean body kick.
Tony definitely struggling to find his range here as Kamren is very much now controlling the distance. Big overhand.
Hope landing a good leg kick on the way out. Man, I'm really impressed with the champion here.
Give me some time to think. Well, I'm in the bathroom looking at me. Facing the mirror is all I need.
Wow.
He's landing some.
Wait until the Reaper takes my life. Never gonna get me out alive. I will live a thousand million lives. My patience is waning. Is this entertaining? My patience is waning. Is this entertaining?
We're in the championship rounds. You know, Tony Hope just always seems to be a step behind.
I agree, Jim.
Good body kick by Burton. Again. Good cut kick. Good cut kick. That scores. Tony Hope says, man, I might be down. Let me go.
Yep. Tony is well aware that he has to do some work here, I believe. Oh, man.
Good timing by the challenger. And this is where Burton does not want to be.
Another sweep.
Be careful. You can't go to the well too many times on that spinning heel kick. That's like playing Tekken, and you just hit the buttons a lot and do crazy spinning stuff.
Got to spam the sweep kick if you're playing Mortal Kombat, people.
Yeah, none of these kids know what Tekken is anyway. Tony Hope starting to find his shots, landing the uppercut. Big kick.
Big body kick. Kamren definitely slowing down just slightly this round. Tony Hope picking it up.
30 seconds. Yeah, the challenger, he's finding those openings now.
Big knee
Big
again.
Knee.
Big head kick by Kamren just misses. Woo, a little slick movement by Tony Hope there.
A little bobbing and weaving. I didn't know he could do that.
Another sweep.
Good right hand by the champ. Good return. Title fight. Good right hand time by Burton.
Tony countering expertly. Big head kick from Tony.
Burton coming with the left after using the right, comes in with that big lead hook.
Another spinning back heel kick from Burton.
A surprise, trains under Kelly Leo. So the karate is gonna be a big part of his offense. Eight man separating these two as we have 1 minute left in this fight. Everything it was advertised to be and more.
Big front kick to the face there, Jim. Tony Hope driving Kamren back.
Now he's setting the tone. He's setting his pace.
A little late, though, in the fight here, Jim.
Both guys obviously feeling this breakneck pace. 10 minutes of nonstop action. 15 seconds remaining.
Big
good
elbow.
Spinning elbow. Big smile from Kamren Burton.
right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Before I read this decision, I need everybody to make some noise for these two warriors who just left it all here in the NFC cage. After five rounds, we have ourselves a split decision. Judge A scores this contest 48-47, Burton. Judge B scores this contest 48-47, Hope. And Judge C scores this contest 49-46 for your winner by split decision. And new undisputed NFC Bantamweight Muay Thai champion, the Tony Ho.
We'll put it on your shoulder. So many belts, we can't even fit them on your tiny waist. Your waist is the size of my quads. We're just going to start there, Tony. The champ knows. He said you're thick. You got winded coming up the stairs, Kimberly. That's my guy. That's my guy. Revenge served sweet against a game opponent. Kamren Burton came out here obviously swinging. You came out here swinging, but you wanted that victory even more.
Look, I told y'all in the promo, I come here for violence. Look, this isn't just a sport to me no more. When I come in here, I'm ready to goddamn die in here. I'm telling you, all the war shit. Look, this was fun though. I appreciate the experience. This is probably the most packed out crowd I've been at, and I love it. I love the boos for the people behind me. I love the cheers from my family, friends, and teammates. I love it all.
We love it all. And I know that you said a little something to Kamren after. I know you were congratulating him as well. Did you guys talk about a trilogy?
Look, my goal was to come in here and make this so decisive where y'all don't even want to see a third fight. But look, Cam is he's a game opponent. He's super good. He brings the best out of me. He brings the most tough out of me. So look, we're going to have to run it back for the third time.
Let's ask the crowd. Do you guys want to see a third round? That's what I'm talking about. Jesse Wabel, matchmaker, you heard it first. Make it happen. I would love to see that again as well. Anything you want to say to your friends and family? I know you, all these people stuck around. People usually leave around 10 o'clock. This says a lot.
This is my first time being a co-main event. Next time, I'm looking for the main event spot. So look, I'm glad all y'all stayed to watch, my family, my friends. Y'all packed this one out, for sure. I see y'all over there, even though I got my glasses. I see y'all, I appreciate y'all, my teammates at Bangkok, my teammates at GTA. I appreciate all of y'all, y'all all made me better.
You guys, clap it up, put your hands together for the new Thai Bantamweight champion, Tony Hope.